What's going on, guys? It's the fish, and I've got another nice little video for you. I'm doing a quick draft Zendikar Rising. With a couple of packaronis. Lotus Cobra, we need some of those. I also have a draft token. You guys should be seeing some more drafts in the near future. What do we got here? 800. Can't afford it. I'm too poor. Alright. Looks like we're going blue-green. This thing is pretty good. Whenever he enters the battlefield, he gets +1/+1 for each mana spent to cast it. Whenever you cast a kick spell, you may remove 2+1/+1 counters. If you do, copy the spell. Solid card. Ruin Crab is just so good too. Such a good card in draft. We're probably gonna be trying to get some landfall-y trigger things. Got this big thing. This Rabid Bite is pretty good. The Roiling Regrowth is also really good. So we're gonna take that instead of the removal. Hopefully we'll see some more removal in the future. Look how spell sacrifice creature. It's not bad. This guy is really good too. I really am not trying to play like black or red, because I've just played it so much, but that guy's kind of hard to ignore. Huh. I haven't seen that thing yet. Battlefield with a +1/+1 counter for each color of mana I spent to cast it. Well, if we're going three colors, that could be right. Black and white is a possibility. Hmm. This is some just solid removal for green. Nice. Flying, kicker X, X can't be zero. When things are entered into the battlefield, if it's kick, gain control of target artifact with converted mana cost X or less. If that artifact is an equipment, attach it to him. So he's a flying 2/1 most of the time, but there is like some, definitely some artifacts that could be just stolen. And I'm trying to play, I guess, blue green. So we're gonna take that since we're in those colors. Probably gonna take a second one of these and start trying to get +1/+1 counters. Yeah, it looks like we're not going to be running the red, thankfully. We're going to top X cards in your library, where X is 3, plus the number of creatures in your party. Put 3 of those cards in your hand, and the rest in the bottom of your library, in a random order. Whew. 5 mana for 3 cards. And there's this. This thing is really good, too. But this is really good, just drawing those cards. I don't really have any like draw stuff yet, so we're gonna take that. That'll be like our one draw spell. Ooh, nice. Very nice. Yeah, I needed one more of these for my big green deck, so that's solid. There is a removal, but we're definitely gonna take that. Okay. I need to start getting some kicked things too. This would actually be great with my other thing. We're gonna take this flying though. We don't have any flying really yet. So there are kicker things. Some more kicker stuff. We need that removal really bad. I forgot what we took the last time. We had the option to get removal, but we didn't take it. Up to 1 target creature, -2 until end of turn, and they mill 2 cards. Already got some rogues going on here. Got a little bit of removal, which is better than no removal. I don't know if the roiling regrowth is going to be that good. because I definitely need some more removal. I'm going to take this big thing. Sentinel. Whenever land enters battlefield, under your control, put a +1/+1 counter on territorial. So this is what we need. We need a lot of these guys. This is a good spell. But we're not going to take that. We want as many of those territorial scythe casts as possible. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to run two Broken Wings in my deck. I really don't think so. But I might just... I might not have any removal at all, so... Keep that in the sideboard just in case. We'll take that. It's an uncommon. And we're just getting crappier. Oh, we got the plus one, plus one. And a Ruin Crab. I need this Valakut Awakening, but... This Ruin Crab could just potentially win me the whole game, because it's good. I do want to just pick the take this because I need this card, but we're gonna take the Ruin Crab. So this is really good, but it costs 8 mana, which is pretty intense. The only other thing really I could definitely take is this Dauntless Survivor, because it has the plus one stuff. I don't think we're going to be running two of those. I might not be running this Roiling Regrowth as well. So at the moment, I only have one of these guys. I need Might of Murasa. I need one of those, definitely. I'm going to take that, though, just because of the potential for it. So we're definitely going to take the Survivor, I think. This guy is also really good. Like, he's a super solid card. Okay, good. This is a great removal. Great land if I potentially need it. Take the flyer. The Gnarled Colony. The Stalker is pretty solid. Cunning is pretty good, but we're gonna take that. We got another one of these. That sucks. I don't want to run two of those in my deck. We're gonna take it, put it on the sideboard. Sideboard. Nice. We got one of these. How's our creatures doing? Our creatures are great. Yeah, we needed that for sure. Need that. Pulling the gate. So we need to cut, I guess, 6 cards. that in there. Probably cut that guy too. So I gotta take two more things out. The Vastwood Surge, if I kick it, it's crazy. 2+1/+1 counters on each creature I control. So we're gonna keep that. We gotta figure out two more things to cut. It's probably gonna be that guy. The Merfolk Wind Robbers could be solid. Choose our creature kill, play +1 counter for each creature in your party. Okay, so I have Rogue, Warrior. Wizard. It's really not much though, but for each creature you park, there's a possibility that I just won't even have my party to even trigger anything, so that could be a dead card, so I'm going to take that out. Ooh, Vault Progress, nice. We gotta open that, right? Let's finish this deck first. Hold on. So we got 8 and 9, so that's 17. And we got 1. Two. Three of those lands. So we're gonna actually cut. We're gonna cut a forest. And I think I'm gonna add could add the negate. The negate could be pretty good. I could just add this Zulaport Duelist. I don't wanna put another one of these in there. I could just put this big bomb, the 5/4 bomb. Or something in between. How are we doing on flying? A couple flying things. So it's either gain 3 life or this guy that could be kicked. And that whenever you cast a kick spell, you may remove 2+1. If you do copy that spell, you may choose new targets. Your current spell becomes a token. So, yeah, we're going to take that. Okay. That seems solid to me. I'm gonna open this box, the vault. Nice. Very nice. I really needed some of those rares. We have 3 rares. Alright, I'll be able to finish my rogue deck completely. Which is nice, having like a solid standard deck. I played that rogue deck yesterday. I did edit it. And I went out of like 8 or 9 games, I won almost every one of them again. So that rogue deck is pretty savage. I could have built this deck a lot faster. But I just, you know, I like talking about some of this stuff with you guys. So hopefully you enjoy that. This seems like a really solid hand, even though it's 4 land. But like I was saying, just getting a Rune and Crab out could just one of these guys could win you a whole game. It's crazy. That's like a 10 turn clock kind of if you hit your lands. Thank you. I'm just going like full aggressive aggro right now, trying to get all my stuff out. I feel like the Horn Beetle is pretty good. I really wish I got like a couple more of these guys. That would have been great. To attack right now, but he could block my guy, and that would be terrible. He could block with this guy and kill him. I want to get this guy as big as possible. So I'm gonna end the turn and try to flash this guy in. Could just drop this guy too. I think I'm gonna flash in the flyer. Just, I wanna start getting some damage in on this dude. If possible. And then also, I mean, I probably won't, but it gives me the option to counter something, for one. I think it's worth countering that. Could. Death touch. Do I counter this thing? Nope. I'm not. Be able to give this guy death touch, which stinks, but oh man, I don't have the green for this. That sucks. Alright, so I don't want to do this yet because I could take control of that guy. Every turn. Yeah, this ruin crab has just this single ruin crab has almost won me this game. Down to 8 cards, you are. Oh, I forgot to play this guy and get the trigger. Shit. Well, we're gonna kick this guy. Attack here. Sucks playing this guy and like missing that trigger, but oh well. So I would have gotten a 1/1 from him. I would have gotten a 1/1, and this guy would be bigger. Alright, I gotta destroy this now. We're down to 3 cards, though. Jeez. And that's game. Let's go, Ruin Crab. Game 2. We're keeping it. Ruin crab all day. Keeping that shit. Oh my god. Not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world. I can. I've got a thieving skydiver too. This guy's pretty much always just a 3-2, and he's not going to be getting that draw card ability. Because I think I have... This may be the only wizard I actually have in the deck. So play this guy, and then put a +1/+1 counter on it. Okay, kill my dude. I can make him a 3/3. I'm gonna wait and make him big. Try to get him out as like a 5/5 so I can trigger his ability twice if need be. And this guy's gonna put the counter on himself and I'm just gonna hopefully trade. Could give him. Could give it to this guy. We're not gonna do that. No, I'm gonna block that. Okay, nice little Azula port right there. I am gonna be dropping this 6/5 trampler. That's not something. I might just try to trade these two. So I think I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna make that trade. I guess we're getting a 4/4. Six, six. That's when I wish, like, I had a negate open for shit like that. Negate can be so good. And then sometimes in draft it just sits in your hand. But Oh, that would be sweet if I could kick that. Huh. Whenever you cast an instant sorcery or wizard spell, put a charge counter on all charge counters, deals that much damage to target creature. Okay. Whenever you cast. You could play that, even if, though I have a negate to counter it, still trigger this and kill my territorial sky cave. Oh, what the hell? Well, that's really not good. That's just gonna happen. I had a good chance, but. Oh, that rabid bite would have been so good. Yeah, if he didn't have that, I probably would have won the game. I guess I should have saved the negate for that, but, yeah, that's it. Back in a couple minutes, guys. Getting right back into the field. I'm ready to go. I'm glad I'm not playing black-red I have just had some bad experiences. So we're not going to be keeping this. Mull to 6. Oh. Just kept it. Not intentionally. Not intentionally. And it's paying off. Could I get him off at some point? Willow, come here. So he's passed the turn to me. He flashed this in and, wow, okay. So I guess I am gonna play blocker. Yeah, I'm just gonna play it. No attacks. This could have been a big, big, big leader, but. And I should have played this land, because now it's gonna take another turn to get this dude out. Slowing the game down a little bit. So this will be great in combination with this thing. I think I'm gonna try to get a little sneaky attack. Can they? They could potentially double block. I'm gonna go with the sneaky attack. The counter gives him menace too. Oh, that was bad. That is bad. Okay, so let's make our attack. don't have anything that has landfall trigger yet. So, you know what? I'm just going to play land. Let's get it out there. So when I made that attack and did all those shenanigans, that was just not a good move. Because he just gaining that plus one messed me up. So we're gonna play our kicked guy. Hopefully he doesn't have a counter. So I'm gonna get 2/1/1s out of that. Did it really tap? Oh my god. Tapped both of my greens. I guess it had to. Okay. Double green. I was trying to kill this guy off because he's going to bring me a 7 now. That's not good. I think for right now we're gonna do this plunder. 1, 2, 3. I'm actually gonna have my 4/4 fight him. Because if he has tricks. Oh yeah, that's how that spell works. Dirt. I'm gonna play this land. I need as many lands possible out. Do I start attacking? In this situation, yeah. I think so. I think I should have attacked with my 2/2 as well. Alright, so he's gonna go in for 3. The next turn, another 3. Doing big swings here. So I have the broken wings. That too much attacking? Hmm. I gotta whittle them down a little bit somehow. I have a broken wings and a negate. Let the counter happen. And kill this while he is tapped down. So it sucks losing my dude. That 6/5 guy. But tis. Or my 3/4 guy. I guess it could have been this guy though. So we're gonna get our Skyclave Sentinel back to not tapped, which will be good. What was the spell that tapped it? For tap target creature, its control mill, so execution, and draw a card. So it's pretty solid. Return target creature card and up to one target. Did he mess that up? Oh no, he didn't. Okay. So I still have the 4/4. Yikes. If I play this, that's a wizard. He costs. Oh no, it's that guy. Okay. Yep, we gotta just get this guy, I think. No attacks. I do want to attack, but he'll do the same thing. And put a count block and like put a counter on one of his guys with the menace. Okay. So if we kill his blocker and make a just straight swing out, how much damage is that? I've got tramplers. I'm gonna just try it. Do it with my 6/5 too. Swing out. I have a negate, so if he's got some kind of tricks, I've got the negate for it. Thank you. I was not considering the rogue being a possibility. So should keep stuff like that in mind. When keeping a two land in hand pays off on accident. So I don't know how I feel about this, but it's gotta be good, right? Do I play a 2/2? Probably not. Probably hold on to him. Much rather have a big 4/4 on the 2/2. Alright, that fledgling is going to be very problematic. I may just straight up die to this thing. I mean, that's what the card does, for God's sake. Crappy situation. I'd rather trade these two than this big guy. What do we have to deal with the 4/4? I would have to draw removal and have a creature, a big, like a 4/4 or 5/5 to kill it. Yeah, this is just the straight up equipment deck. I don't know why he didn't put the indestructible on that guy. If he did, I would have just blocked with the Ruin Crab. But so fudge. Yeah, I think that's pretty much game. Might as well try this. I guess I could have played the Thieving Skydriver and blocked, and that would have saved me like one more turn, but that was a play mistake, but I'm pretty sure I would be dead anyway. I don't have anything to deal with this. This guy's deck is pretty solid. Bravo. White, red, green. Seems like a good color combination. Turn one, turn two, turn three. Savage stuff going on here. This is my second draft of this set, by the way. I drafted black red. I think I mentioned this before, but I just got wrecked. It was terrible. All right, two wins, three losses, pretty bad. Not happy about this draft. But I got to see some more of the set, play some more of the set. You can't win everyone. I've been saying this for a while, but I want to try to draft Celestia. And that guy's, the last guy's deck, one of them, that was just bad news bears. Just followed up one with the 1, 2, and 3 drops. That was bad luck. But yeah, I've got a token, I got gems, so I'm going to be doing a lot more drafting, and I'll be able to actually draft this set, so I'm excited about that. If you guys liked the video, please give it a like, comment, subscribe, And have a good rest of the day. Peace, homies.